Hello everyone, I'm Emilia Mayo. I'm a male to female, proud, heterosexual, transgender woman who lives in Südtirol, but originally I'm Hungarian and I'm an artist. On my channel you can find out details about how I experiencing my own gender identity. I hope you find this one, this video also interesting. If yes, thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Yeah, it was my 2 years anniversary, so on the hormone therapy, sorry. So I would like to talk about the things which I was not expected before I started the hormone therapy, and what maybe you would like to know before you start. So let's start. Like I've said, I come from Hungary, and at the present my biggest issue, which I have not imagined before, and I guess who lives in USA or in UK is not a problem at all, or not even most of the European countries, is now I look like a woman. I misgendered, fortunately. Everybody recognized me like a woman, but my personal identification officially is still my dad name. So it's like I have born, and it's not possible to change, because Hungary changed the law when the COVID pandemic started to protect our nations. So that I couldn't imagine, because before it was possible. And yeah, actually here in Italy, when I finished my examination by psychiatrist, then I got the possibility to change my name and my gender if I could be Italian. So my biggest target now is to go back to go in, but finally into Italy, because Südtirol is a kind of Austria in Italy, and study the language and get the citizenship in Italia. And in the Hungarian embassy they said maybe if Italy accepts me like a transgender woman, then maybe Hungary will do, or if the government change. But yeah, it could be a wonder. Maybe bigger than that, than I actually became a cis woman. So yeah, that I could not wait, but I guess most of us, or who is in the fortunate part of the world, is not became a problem. Which for me was the most experimental part in these 2 years, it was how it changed my sexuality. I still have not seen, and I have not read many studies over on this topic, which a pretty taboo and I guess a pretty unknown part of our transition, because many studies thinking on how our hormone level change our body by seeing, I mean how we look like, our appearance, and most of the study focusing that one, much less study focusing on the long-term hormone therapy health issues, which I think already is a kind of problem. And for example, because I don't have dysphoria with my genitals, but it I have heard, and I mean that real consideration of vasectomy, I hope I'm saying well, when your testicles are gone, basically, which of course then you don't need the blockers, because it's a really heavy stuff, it's dangerous for your kidney and your liver in long term. Not mention the hormones to take, if you don't have that much testosterone, then you don't need that much estrogen to keep your level up, so I have seen other Tangshan res who finally stopped to take estrogen. Either they had even the vaginoplasty and everything, because they find that much healthier than keep it up with laser therapy, the appearance and so on. And if you don't, your body is not changed by testosterone, then maybe it's work. I don't know if it's with long term how it is. It's a way which I have not known before, and of course because of my age it was not possible to change, to decide. I guess when you are younger and your look is much more feminine, then it's a possibility to choose after the first few years. But I have no idea about this. Not mention, I had no idea how affect everything hormones, and not only appearance, also my mental state and also my really my sexuality. I mean, how I can enjoy my loving partner. Sometimes it was shocking, and sometimes was really surprising, in a positive way and in a negative way. I have said before with the problems with the erection and the pain because my sex drive went down. I have sex drive, so many Tangshans said is decreased dramatically. I simply saying is different. I don't feel the sex drive like before, or like I said the previous week. Yeah, now I didn't felt like that. Now it starts to turn back, which was again a surprising, and you have no forget. You must not forget I'm in the 2 years, so the changing of my body will finish around 3 years, so it's still going through some adventures like that, when actually I feel the urge like when I was in board mode. But before, I really didn't fight at all, so I didn't know I have to keep practice that part of my body to not have problem later. And that's, I guess, something which you may know, because to get that pain every time when you are attracted for someone, and I had nearly a year to heal, was pretty frustrating, and I could avoid that if I have any information about this. Not mentioned to avoid the panic when my doctor said I should have no erection, and he predicted me I have cancer. So if you have erection, you should know, no, it's not something which is unusual. 50% of Tangshans experience that. Which I also would like to know before I start my hormone therapy. It's yeah, you have to consider things before. I mean, you may know at the moment you want vaginoplasty or other drastic steps. I think it's better to let everything by time, but it's better to be prepared with information than shocked by the surprise, because when I have seen, for example, this really good theater online talking about Tangshans experiences, I was not considering at all vaginoplasty till then, but then she told us we can develop gender dysphoria with that part and finally we're really looking like woman, and the only things which is not really right is our genitalia. And I was thinking, yeah, maybe she has right, because yeah, I like swimming. I was never a big fan of nudist trans, FKK, but you know, in Germany it's a really big tradition, and I was thinking on it, maybe I would like to try. But then is coming the problem when I'm not dressed up and I'm not with someone who I love, I'm simply in public, then it can be a problem. So she advised, okay, maybe at present you don't want and you don't feel dysphoria, but better to get a doctor and find a good one and get an appointment, because usually it's need years. Then you develop a gender dysphoria there and you have to suffer for years because you have to wait. And then I was considering, yeah, that's pretty good advice, and I guess I will look in now. Also, if I'm quite sure I don't want now, but I don't know until I finish my completely my changing, I will not desire to change that too. Because for example, for me now, which I also didn't expect, I look like a woman and I attract the right persons, but the right person still not able to accept me like a woman because of that. Okay, I'm thinking I will not change myself for anyone and they should accept me, so maybe you say they are not the right person. But when you get this all the time, yeah, makes me thinking. So yeah, basically only this now, not mention the present big news about my, I'm turning back a little bit in the boy mode, but that I already have said the last week, so if you would like to know more about it, then check it out. I hope you liked this video, thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and see you soon.